Hello world, I'm Brancliff. Let's continue to dig through the screenshots from my old computer. A long time ago, there was an event where they would give out mystics that are color themed by the cast. The problem is, it was random which one you got. They gave me the Eve-themed mystic, which I then gave to my ad and named Eve. Yeah, I'm a bad person for that. Though the funny thing is, I didn't have any strong feelings for or against Eves back then. Nowadays, I sometimes feel like I give them more crap than Aura players because they're more universally understood as rich and sometimes snobby, while most people don't share the same experience with Aura mains that I have. Here's a screenshot from my wedding when I married my, Elsword girlfriend. How many more of these videos do I have to make before I don't have to talk about her anymore? For some reason, I didn't have a costume canon yet, and there weren't as many people here, even though our guild has gotten along. And why didn't I take the screenshot during the wedding cutscene itself? Here's a screenshot with a funny megaphone. Normally, the megaphone wouldn't be too particularly noteworthy on its own, but the pose my Aisha was doing at the dungeon clear matched up with it really well. It just made for a really well-timed screenshot. That said, I'm glad character model revamps have taken place since then, because I just face looks kind of funny in this one. It's kind of like how in Elsword the animation, they always give Aisha the goofy expression for some reason. Here's a screenshot of me in Altera's secret dungeon with a complete party wipe. I don't remember if I ended up having to solo at the dungeon afterwards or what. That said, notice how I only have one res in this screenshot. You know how if you have less than 10 res, you're brought back to 10 at the nightly reset? It wasn't like that back then. I think it only went up to 3. So I wasn't willing to use my res on these dips. I'm not carrying Wonderwall, which was a TT skill back then in the screenshot, so maybe it was my fault. Because hey, it turns out that SDs were actually hard back then. I mean, look at this timer. It starts at like, what, 12 minutes? Now it's down to a little under 4 and we're not even at the boss yet. Weird times. Here's a screenshot of me with my sparring equipment on. My stats weren't anything special for this. In fact, they were actually pretty bad PvP stats. They were spread out really thinly and I don't know why I was running crit, but somehow I had triple S anyway. Weird. While my stats aren't anything special here, it's still interesting to see how the stat window looked back then and how it's changed since. For example, there's no light mode, dark mode option, the accuracy and evasion stats were still there, and there were 9 accessory slots instead of 11. There was also an empty space where the resonance window ended up being. Here's a screenshot of my Hellsword girlfriend and I leveling up our characters as we try switching mains temporarily. You can barely tell in the screenshot, but I have the awesome Aisha fashion that I put together that took me 3 hours to make. But what's really important here is this glitch that says you have failed to get out of the village. It was weird for me. I've never seen that error before and I haven't seen it since, so I don't know what it was really about. But even then it's wrong, because shouldn't it say you have failed to get in the village? Also of note is my skill setup for this one. Back then, Blaze Step was actually usable. Mana Shield existed, though let's be honest, getting rid of that was probably a good thing. And yet again, I have an empty skill slot and I don't know why. Here's a screenshot of me leveling up what would end up becoming my Fatal Phantom. In this screenshot, Chunk says, if these Nasods are created only to harm others, my destroyer will serve justice. I took this screenshot because I guess I hated Chunk x Eve back then still. The funny thing about this is, before various changes in the story and future content, for a long time, this screenshot was true. Nasods were only created to harm others, but then everyone traveled to a different dimension, Aura got groped by a robot Shota, and then everyone like flew to heaven or something. Here's another screenshot I took with the same Chung, where I did this awesome pose with an Elysis. I have no idea how this screenshot turned out so well, or, well, I say that, but look how goofy the destroyer looks as it gets closer to the camera. Still though, this was a really lucky screenshot, but I have to say, what am I even doing here? If I'm holding the gun, that means I'm already job advanced, so why am I in Bantha's cave again? Maybe it's because the skill quest were a lot harder back then. Alright, so at this point, I've realized that the script I wrote for this episode is definitely way too long for one episode, so I'm gonna awkwardly split it up here. In 2 more weeks, we'll check out some more old screenshots. Tell me if you get the feels from watching this, or if you have any old stories you want to share. Check out your old screenshots folder if you think you still have it. I'm Brancliff. Goodbye, everyone.